Good morning. Welcome to Apple Park. This year, we have significant updates across the entire lineup. So let's start off with the new generation of AirPods. Here's Kate to tell you more.
AirPods 4 build on the original industry-defining design, loved by millions of people. To make these AirPods even more convenient to charge and carry with you everywhere you go, the charging case has USB-C. Next, there's AirPods Max. We're excited to introduce beautiful new colors, along with USB-C, making AirPods Max even more convenient to charge. These are the breakthrough updates and category-defining innovations that take the entire AirPods product line to the next level.
Do you also feel like new products are not that exciting? You wish you could just upgrade the ones you already have instead of buying new ones? For the past year, I've been selling those kits to get the updated USB-C port on your AirPods.
But they take some time to install and you need tools, and that means you can potentially damage the device while installing them. What if we could make it truly mainstream? No tools needed. What if I showed you this and this? Do you get it? It's the story of a protection case and an adapter that have a child. It's a smart protection case. And turns out I've got pretty much all the equipment in my shop to make it a reality. So let's engineer it. Okay, not quite there. But before I go any further, I need to have at least a concept of a plan. So what comes first? Should I design the plastic case or the electronics first? It's the chicken or the egg problem. The answer is that I can start with both. While my attempts at printing, I can work on the electronics. The first goal is to make a case that has a perfect fit, no electronics included.
So now we have a first draft of the mechanical part, let's move over to the electronics part.
So the whole trick is that I want to use a small lightning connector that will plug in the case. So let me turn to my contacts in China and see what they have in stock. Yeah, too big. Looks weird. Too big. That one looks pretty good. It's only one-sided, so that's perfect because the real lightning port has two sides. So I'm not selling stuff that infringes their patent. And I only need one side anyway. Let's bring it into the design. So what will be the shape of the electronic circuit? Well, that depends on what my priorities are. If I want to simplify cost and manufacturing, I would do it like that with a rigid PCB, but my main goal is to make it as small as possible. Now I need to figure out the smallest possible circuit I can come up with. I went through a lot of possibilities, but most of them had components on two sides of the PCB. That takes longer to manufacture and it makes it more expensive. But I found this way where everything is on the same side. I think the bend radiuses should work.
Famous last words.
Okay, now I can try to integrate it in my protection case. I basically add the least amount of plastic around the PCB that I can get away with, and then I smooth it out as much as my CAD program will allow. Also, you know we hate glue on this channel, so we add some good old screws to hold all that. Same as always, I designed the flexible circuit and just sent over the files over to my good friends at PCBWay. I was in a bit of a rush, so I chose the fastest option they have, and it only takes a couple of days to arrive. Awesome. Now, this is not a video where I half-ass the job and make promises that are hard to keep. I wanted to come out with a big bang, you know, so it's available for all models right from the beginning. So while we wait for the circuit boards to arrive, let me order some AirPods to make 3D models. My big problem is that I want to save money, so it doesn't make sense for me to buy brand new pairs just for this. Here's the first case I received, AirPods Pro 2.
Something seems odd.
It's fake!
Yep, super fake. Looks like it was made by the Axe company. You know what gave it away? This line that ran through the case is not supposed to be there.
Okay, I have a confession to make.
This is the third time I've been scammed buying used AirPods. I just keep getting fake pairs. It's so annoying. But thankfully, the solution to this problem magically appeared in my email inbox. So this company called Backmarket reached out, and they're a premium marketplace for used devices. So that's perfect for me because it just removes all the issues with quality, authenticity, and just like receiving the goods, you know.
So I hop on Backmarket's website, place my order, and here are my used AirPods a few days later. Very soon, I'm not gonna need that anymore. Yep, okay, looks great. Okay, the cases are ready and I've received my PCBs. Now we add some paste, place it on a pick and place machine and let it do its job. Ha! But how do I get those connectors in place? Well, I made this cool little tray and it will just pick them up one by one. Smart, right? Well, not so much. Looks like it's got this curved shape and I can't find any nozzle that works well with it. Guess I will just place them by hand. Now it goes into my favorite
vapor phase reflow oven.
I plan to do another video giving more details on the whole production aspect of my lab, the behind the scenes if you will. Leave a comment if you want to see that. Okay, here it comes. Oh no, okay, what the hell. Yeah. So that'll teach me to be overconfident when I buy shady lightning connectors online. The plastic inside the connector doesn't resist the 230 degrees Celsius of the oven. So the oven did its job perfectly, it's just a bad quality connector. You can actually see how well the oven works by how uniform the melting is. Never mind, I'm gonna solder the new connector by hand for now, it's a problem for later. But I'm just too excited to see if it works. Okay, I figured out what was wrong. I was way too optimistic with the whole bending situation. I have a trace on there that becomes too fragile and cracks when I bend it too much. I need to make a new PCB, but I think I need a break first.
So okay, I lost $500, but you know what I gained? Experience.
No eye protection.
No. Experience. No.
I've been back in the shop for a few days, I redesigned the whole thing, and here is what it looks like. It looks great! I tweaked the design slightly, but now everything is perfect. Okay, I'm almost done with all those designs, but I realize now that I have one last problem if I want to make a true consumer-grade product. Right now, I print the parts in the Formlabs Fuse printer, then I remove the excess powder in the sift station, and then to get a good result, I blast them manually with a glass media in order to properly remove all residual powder. The finish is never very uniform and it just takes so much time. Sadly, I'm a human, not a robot, but I can buy a robot to do that. If you've been following closely, we have one last model that didn't get the treatment. That's right, those bad boys. And I'm pretty sure it will be the most popular one. But look at those nice curves, they go in all directions. Where could I place this USB-C connector? Here looks pretty good. I'll spare you all the struggles, but basically I had to model the whole thing and then I could build a shape around my model and subtract the curves, which gives this. It's super light, which means you can just plug it in and it stays attached through the lightning connector. It's not going anywhere. If you want to use the lightning port because you don't have the right cable, just unplug it and set it aside. They're made out of tough nylon 12 plastic, they have this great rugged texture, anyone can install them in 10 seconds, your dad, your cousin, your grandma, anyone. Yes, even your grandma. It's available right now for every single model of AirPods. The internal kits are still available too, if you prefer that.
So, in terms of pricing, it will be the same as the cases sold on Apple's website, but mine have electronics inside.
You can find everything on shop.kenpi.io. Everything is obviously open source again, link in the description. And same as always, I'm doing a giveaway on my other social media channels.
thank you so much for watching. If you like what you saw, I'm not going anywhere, so I've got a ton of new engineering projects coming up. So please consider subscribing if you want to see more. And there's one more thing I haven't showed you.
They can stand up.
Peace.